cabrón.
What can I get y'all?
Thank you.
Paola's caprese salad. She would make that for me whenever I came back from the hunt.
I know, it's your favorite. Although how you could have an appetite now is beyond me.
I am always hungry for my Angel.
Beauty is blind. Brava! Bravissima! A tidal wave of applause washed over Justine as roses rained down on the stage. It's a wonder they don't hit me, she thought bitterly. I'm the largest target for miles. After curtain down, she retired to her dressing room, set her horned Viking helmet aside, and waddled up to the mirror with a gelatinous jiggle. There was a knock at the door, and Henry Wallin appeared. Henry again. Cheers, Louise.
You were magnificent, Miss DiVangelo. Did you see? The papers are calling you the finest soprano of the 19th century.
He looked at the floor and shifted his feet uncomfortably.
Every man in town loves you.
Stupid Henry, moaned Justine as she examined her profile in the mirror. No real man could love a fat twat like me. She tried adjusting her midriff. Disgusting. She waited for the sigh, but today Henry's response was different. There was a rustle, a metallic thunk.
Good evening to you, my lady.
She heard the clack of the door. Justine gazed wistfully at the tintype of beautiful Bella Margot, the slender soprano she idolized in her youth. What was Bella's secret, she wondered, as she picked away at a box of truffles on the table.
What indeed?
A few minutes later, Justine was bent over the wastebasket by the door, gagging and heaving. Eventually, she gave up and removed her finger from her throat. Then, at the bottom of the wastebasket, she saw the roses and the letter and remembered the rustle and the thunk. She opened the letter and read aloud.
You have won my heart, and that is no small feat.
Oh, how sweet!
No small feat, she shouted in rage. A large feat, is that it?
She crumpled up the note, threw it on the floor, and stomped on it for good measure. Something inside of her had snapped. From that moment forward, she was determined to never sing again. Her voice could go to hell, just as long as she could be beautiful.
No one knows exactly what happened to Justine after that. Not the impresario who had begged her to come back, not the reporters who had begged her to comment, not Henry, who had been too crushed to face her again.
Correct me if I'm wrong, G, but didn't Henry want to be crushed? I mean, come on, chubby chaser, anyone?
When Justine's landlord finally let himself in, he was startled to discover a slim and beautiful woman in his tenant's armchair. She was naked, and her throat had been savaged. The blood had painted an inverse bouquet of roses on her chest. The woman held her own vocal cords in her hands. Oh, the end.
Thank you.
Where I speak now instead of holding my peace.
Shut up. Paula! It's really you, isn't it?
You came for me. I'm so happy. I can't tell you how long I've been here.
I'm sorry it took me so long, baby.
No apology. apologies, Garcia. You're here. That's what's important.
There, there, Chief. Inside every good girl is a bad girl just waiting to get out.
Danger, puta, then put on your best dress, because tonight I am taking you out.
Come on.
Check it out! I think I found a banging underground shortcut. This should take us right under the castle walls. Who's your skull, G?
You are, Johnson. My numbskull. You led us right into the catacombs.
Yes, but it's a dry heat.
Or is this juice jockey angrier than the others?
He looks ready to explode, and that's not a figure of speech.
Thank you. Oh!
Ugh, this reminds me of the most horrid story. A gaggle of demon hags thought they could get ahead in the world by offering to join Fleming's harem. But he was so offended by their hideousness that he ripped off their heads and used the sloppy carcasses for bowling pins. Ever since, bowling for uglies has been one of his favorite forms of torture.
So instead of getting ahead, they lost a head?
This is nothing to joke about, G. Get your mind out of the gutter.
Your girl's gone mental again.
She's not mental. She is momentarily confused.
your girl's gone mental again.
She's not mental. She's momentarily confused.
Gone mental again.
She's not mental. She is momentarily confused.
Girl's gone mental again.
She's not mental. She is momentarily confused.
Girl's gone mental again.
She's not mental. She is momentarily confused.
Girl's gone mental again.
She's not mental. She is momentarily confused.
Gone mental again.
She's not mental. She is momentarily confused.
Your girl's gone mental again.
She's not mental. She is momentarily confused.
Girl's gone mental again.
She's not mental. She is momentarily confused.
Girl's gone mental again.
She's not mental. She is momentarily confused.
Like these, that I wish that guy from the cabin hadn't been torn into tiny little bits. We could use another gunman. Now that you mention it, doesn't that mean his soul has been damned to the underworld? Gee, quick, blow up the plugs!
Ah!
I'm a happy trade. You all got stones, but you got any gems?
Thank you.
Want to stay on the down low, but the catacombs? Well, that's crazy talk. Happy trails!
Cabron! Motherfucker!
Thank you.
devil! Crowded out there! Wait, let me guess. I'm going to open this door again and all the demons will be gone, right?
It was a nice thought, Gene.
Thank you.
crowded out there. Wait, let me guess. I'm going to open this door again and all the demons will be gone, right?
It was a nice thought, Jim.
Thank you.
Let's go and see what's behind that door.
What does that mean?
Must be a joke from the designers.
The who? Who are these comedians?
I believe they're guardians of this room. Each has the ability to control a piece of the puzzle.
Is there any way to shut them up?
Shut me down one of their throats and I'll let you know. Garcia, it smelled atrocious in there.
What's so funny, bitch face? I don't hear you laughing now. I don't hear you laughing now.
that spinner. Hurry!
Ugh.